Is it possible to bring completely extinct creatures back to life? Actually, there is no single answer to this question. The most recent example of this is the mammoth, which scientists believe could be reintroduced by 2027. Colossal company with large budget has taken on this mission. But has science really advanced that far? If mammoths can be brought back into the world, I can hear you saying, why not dinosaurs? We have a little problem with that. About 63 million years, mammoths became extinct about 3,700 years ago. Did you know when there was the last mammoth on Earth? The pyramids were already built, and they were even 800 years old. Dinosaurs lived and extinct about 66 million years ago. From this perspective, the extinction of mammoths doesn't seem like a long time ago, does it? But before we think about it that way, we'd better tell you a little bit about the structure of DNA. You know that the genetic building block of biological living things is DNA. The numbers 0 and 1 are the codes that make up the building blocks of a computer program, or the video you are watching right now. This is called binary encoding. There are 4 building blocks of DNA: adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine. These are also called nucleotides. Humans have approximately 3.2 billion nucleotides in their DNA, and each different sequence creates features that distinguish individuals from one another. Mammoths have a very close relative still alive today, Asian elephants. Mammoths have 99% of their genes the same as Asian elephants. Here for the remaining 1%, it is planned to bring the mammoths back to Earth by completing the well-preserved mammoth DNA samples we have. Well, just like in the movie Jurassic Park, why can't we find and sample? There is a very simple reason for this. The half-life of DNA is 521 years. Experts say that even under perfect conditions, DNA bonds will disappear completely within 6.8 million years at the most. The youngest dinosaur fossil ever found is 65 million years old. Let's say we were able to find a partial DNA sample. To complete this, as with mammoths, dinosaurs have no close living relatives. Do not immediately think of crocodiles or reptiles. The closest relatives of dinosaurs today are chickens. They don't look very much like relatives, do they? Meanwhile, the missing genes in the movie Jurassic Park were completed from frogs. I guess it didn't work for them to show the chickens in the movie. In fact, at the time the movie was made, there was no technology to make up for missing genes. We currently have this technology. The name of this technology is CRISPR. We can also call it scissors and tweezers made of some kind of protein, but we cannot fit this complex technology into this video. Maybe it will be the subject of another video. While we are discussing the scientific side of the topic, we may actually be forgetting the ethical side. It is not possible to give birth to dinosaurs in today's technology. But genetic engineering has advanced significantly in recent years, leading to the birth of babies who were genetically designed to be resistant to diseases. In China, the government sentenced a doctor who did this to prison, as many countries found the development ethically wrong. However, as this technology progresses, new developments and new ethical debates seem to be waiting for us. What do you think about the de-extinction of extinct creatures?